Kelly, and today I'm going to be showing you guys stuff and making some slime. So today, the slime I'm going to be making is Floam, and I'm going to show you two things before we start. It's something I got and a little science experiment. So, first, before I do anything, hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on post notifications so you can see all my videos in the future. And if you subscribe, you'll be one of Ellie's elephants. So, first thing I'm gonna show you is this really cool glitter ball I got. So it has princesses on it, and if you shake it, it's really pink and it's really cool glitter, and then if you hit it, it lights up. So, maybe in one of my future videos, hint hint, I'll cut this open. So, now what I'm gonna show you is a little science experiment. I got this glue the other day. It's the Goes On Purple Dries Clear Glue. It doesn't make slime, but it does make a really cool science experiment. So, if you put a little of this glue into a bowl, it's hard to squeeze. It's purple, right? It's like a dark purple. So, you see how purple? And then, if you add some baking soda to it, you don't have to add too much, I have a little bit. You can see it transform, and it's so weird. It turns clear. Like, what? It said it dries clear. It didn't say it turns clear with baking soda. That stuff is so cool. Now, it doesn't make slime, I'm not sure. I think it's because it's like just like a melted glue stick, because that's what it smells like. So, then I'm doing my slime. So, first you need like a half a cup or a cup of hot water and a half of a teaspoon of borax. Almost picked up the baking soda. Well, I got my half teaspoon. Well, I'll just wipe it off. I'll clean that up later, after I'm done. And then what you gotta do is mix until it's all dissolved. And that's why you should do hot water, because hot water dissolves it faster. So after, I'm gonna set that aside. And then what you need is a bowl, a half of a cup measuring cup, and a spoon. I got a pink one and a pink cup and it matches. So then what you will need is some Elmer's glue. I got a gallon. You probably, for a half of a cup, you will just need like a 4 ounce. So you don't need a whole gallon. So then I'm gonna pour my glue in. Good. And then just pour it into your bowl and make sure to scrape it out so you get every inch of that glue, because you want a big slime. And then just put the cap on and then take some shaving cream and take a half a cup of that. Now shaving cream makes it bigger. It makes it expand so it's more big. And then just give that a good stir. And it smells really good, especially if you use sensitive skin. I mean, if you like the smell of the original one, I guess you could use that, but I like the sensitive skin a lot more. And then just take some lotion. My lotion was in my corner because I forgot I needed it. And then take lotion. Just like 2 squirts. And then mix that in. All the lotion does really is make it stretchier. Because, well, you want it stretchy. You don't want it too tough or like rough. And especially when it like gets older over time, that's kind of bad. So then I'm gonna take a food dye. I'm gonna take magenta. Magenta is a really pretty color. These are gel dyes. They're not really like the real color. So that's why it's like jelly. I didn't really find this in the baking aisle, like where the dyes are. I found it in like the, like, I don't know how to say it. It's like the section that you get like the fondant and like the cookie cutters and like baking racks that you put your cakes on. And then all I'm gonna do is mix this in, and this gives it the most vibrant pink you could ever have. It's like bubblegum to the max. Like, this is the prettiest color ever. As you can see, it's really nice. So you just want to get all the white off, because you don't want any white splotchy parts in your slime, or your floam, I should say. And then, what I'm gonna do, my borax is just sitting at the side right now, if you're wondering. What do you have to do now? I know. So you put the borax in until it's non-sticky. So it's just like when I add contact solution for the gel glue slime. So it just gets it nice and thick, and it's so it's not sticky like glue anymore, like glue and shaving cream. So it's really nice, because it's cool to make it like till it's cool to look at it when it's like making, because it's like gets thick and it like, you know when it becomes slime. It's really a cool experience to make some slime. So you just want to get the sides, because you don't want to miss any of your slime. And mine's still a little bit sticky, so I'm going to add a little bit more borax solution. Oops, it splashed. Okay, and then I'm going to start kneading it with my hands, or working it with my hands, until it's non-sticky. I mean, I'm going to have to add borax, but until it's like not too sticky, I'm just going to add some borax into it. And I'm going to tell you what the solutions are for your, like, your options for the solutions. Your options are either borax, like I'm using right now, contact solution like I used with the gel slime, contact solution and baking soda. You have to have baking soda or shaving cream, because shaving cream is just like baking soda. It helps it react and make the slime. But also, there's detergent and liquid starch. I'll probably use those in my future videos. I'm not using them yet because I only have two videos. But yeah, so I'll probably use them in the future ones. And now that I really have a nice slime, I'm gonna put my spatula and my borax to the side. My cup. Just put this over here for now. Oops, got all of this side. So actually, I'm gonna add a little bit of borax. Perfect. But you want it a little bit sticky so the foam beads will attach. So I'll show you guys some poking ASMR. Is you gotta fill a bag or like a little bowl with foam beads, and you gotta drizzle, oops, you gotta drizzle your slime in there, or just get all the foam beads on, and then you gotta work the foam beads into your slime to create a perfect flow. And I love the colors pink and white together. I feel like it looks amazing because like pink and white and black look amazing together. But yeah, and then all you gotta do is really mix it in until you get to like where you can still see slime, but you can barely see it and it looks so cool. And this kind of makes it a crunchy slime, but not like a crunchy slime with beads, just like not too much of a crunchy slime, but like, I guess it could be called crunchy slime. I feel like foam really fits it, because foam. But yeah, it starts to be like really bumpy, and doesn't this look so cool? Like, gonna leave it like this. I don't want to really a lot of foam beads, but yeah, this is really nice. So that is my finished product, and like I said at the beginning of my video, please like and subscribe, and thank you to all of the people that do subscribed already and are my elephants. And I hope you guys turned on your post notifications so you can see this video the day it comes out. So, guys, I hope you like my video and I hope you like my slime. Bye!